Antonio Uje Zen, self-earthing device and rudder bonding cable.
Hello everyone, good day and see you again in my channel. At this occasion, I will discuss about self-earthing device and rudder bonding cable. Self-earthing device and rudder bonding cable is part of impressed current cathodic protection or ICCP. You can watch my previous video about impressed current cathodic protection for your full understanding about self-earthing device and rudder bonding cable. Mainly, the purpose of self-earthing device and rudder bonding installed on board is to avoid spark erosion on the main engine, reduction gear, shaft bearing, or rudder carrier. Oh yeah, you can contribute to development of my educational video by subscribing to my channel. There is nothing to lose by subscribing to my channel. Apart from encouraging me to continue sharing knowledge, you will also get benefit from the information that I share. Anyway, for details about self-earthing device and rudder bonding cable, let's check my animation video. Let's go!
Reason of sub-earthing device and rudder bonding cable installation. A turning propeller and rudder are electrically insulated from the hull by the lubricating oil film in the bearings and by the use of non-metallic bearings materials in the tail shaft and rudder carrier. When the shaft and rudder are insulated, this way an electrical potential can be measured between the shaft and the hull, and this can accelerate corrosion in the ship. If the ship has a system of cathodic protection, whether it is sacrificial anode or an impressed cathodic current protection system, the shaft insulation will prevent the propeller and the boss from receiving protection. The electrical potential between the shaft and the hull can also cause a heavy current to flow in bearings when the oil film breaks down or is contaminated with seawater. This current can cause depitting of the bearing surface. Excessive wear on the shaft bearings can often be traced to this cause. This problem can be eliminated by earthing the propeller shaft to the hull with the help of slip ring and contact brass assembly, and for the rudder to be connected with bonding cable to the ship's hull.
Construction of shaft and rudder.
Following is the name of the parts. Started with aft side, propeller, used to propel the ships by using the power generated and transmitted by the propulsion motor or engine of the ship. Steering is the equipment to turn the rudder. Rudder tool that gives the ship's directional control and a way to steer for navigation. Electric propulsion motor utilize electric power to drive propeller blades for propulsion. Reduction gear, a mechanical device that reduces the input speed and increases the output torque. It typically consists of gears, shaft, and bearings. Propeller shaft to transfer rotational power from engine or motor to the propeller. Intermediate shaft bearing to support shaft propeller consists of metal bearing and lubricating oil. Stand tube shield to prevent ingress of water and to avoid the lubricating oil to escape into the sea and to withstand growth of shaft and propeller. Self-earthing device to reduce the spark erosion. Self-earthing device digital millivolt meter to monitor the potential between the shaft and the hull and verify the effectiveness of the system.
bonding cable to equalize the potential difference between the rudder and the stern hull.
Lubrication oil film electrical insulation of shaft propeller.
Rotating propeller shaft is electrically insulated from the hull by the lubricating oil film in the propeller shaft, which are connected to reduction gears, intermediate shaft bearing, and piston tube shield. Following is the animation video showing how is the oil film insulated shaft propeller. Reduction gear is continuously sprayed with lubricating oil in order to create a film between the moving mechanical parts, ensuring that they can always move freely for cooling, for wear protection, for cleaning, and so on. This oil film electrically insulated shaft propeller from hull during propeller turning. When the oil film breaks down or it is contaminated with seawater, a heavy current to flow in bearings or gears. And this current can cause depitting of the bearings and gear surface. Intermediate bearing is also continuously sprayed with lube oil for lubrication purpose, which is oil film created between bearing and shaft. Stern tube filled with lubrication oil for sealing and lubrication. Therefore, an oil film created in this part also. Sometimes the bearing using non-metallic bearing material. Shaft earthing device part name. Following are the part name of shaft earthing device.
2 pieces slip rings made of silver alloy attached for extension contact of shaft propeller. There are 3 set brush holder, 2 set used for connecting to earthing or grounding part, and 1 set for monitoring or detector part. Brush holder consists of as follow: pan spring and spring clamp.
High density silver graphite brush used for face-to-face contact with slip rings. The effectiveness of the shaft earthing system should ensure a maximum contact resistance of no greater than 0.001 ohms. High silver content brushes running on a silver track have repeatable low conductivity that can maintain these limits and ensure low resistance contact is maintained even under dirty condition. The millifold detector part single brush holder fitted to the base using insulator to isolate flowing signal from the shaft. It used for pick up the voltage potential difference signal from the shaft and sent to digital millifold meter for measurement and displayed in millivolt unit. The value shown in the digital meter indicate the effectiveness of earthing system. The reading of digital millivolt meter showing 0 during shaft stopping.
Ships without shaft earthing device and bonding cable or worn out earthing brass slip rings. Following is the animation showing when a vessel did not install with shaft earthing device or SED and bonding cable or worn out its high silver brass.
Without SED, the propeller and rudder acted as anodes. It oxidized in the electrolyte or seawater and generating electrons. Also, rotating propeller generate a voltage potential difference between the shaft and the hull, which in time will cause damage to the propeller and the bearings due to arc erosion.
Arc erosion can occur due to lubrication oil breakdown, such as contamination with water and high metal contents. When the propeller is at rest, the stern tube, propeller shaft, and main engine bearings are in contact with each other, maintaining continuity of the circuit. When the ship is running, due to the rotation of propeller and lubricating oil film, the shaft become partially electric insulated. When there is no shaft earthing system or defect of silver brass such as high resistance, it can cause the potential energy from shaft unable to flow to hull via silver brass. An electrical potential is developed between the shaft and the hull, which can cause heavy current to flow into reduction gear, main bearings, and thrust bearing, and cause spitting marks. If these effects continue for a considerable amount of time, it may lead to overheating of main engine bearing caused by improper lubrication resulted by cavities from spark erosion.
it may also lead to formation of oil mist, emergency shutdown of the engine, or in extreme cases, crankcase explosion. Self-earthing device and rudder bonding cable system.
Following is the animation video showing how self-earthing device and rudder bonding cable system is working. Self-earthing device, silver gravity brush and slip rings is under good condition, and rudder bonding cable connected to hull body properly. Electric current from ACCP anode flowing to propeller and rudder. The current then passing rudder, rudder stock and bonding cable to get to hull body for earthing. Rudder bonding will equalize the potential difference between the rudder and the stern hull, and hence reduce the risk of detrimental stray current. Lack of electrical connection between the rudder and the stern hull may result in detrimental stray current, causing spark corrosion. Meanwhile, the electric current flow received by propeller passing sub-propeller to be earthed to ship's hull via slip rings and silver graphite brush. Two set of brush holder for optimal contact and lowest resistance used for movable connection between sub and hull. This brush holder has an adjustable spring tensioner, which is supply preset to the standard pressure.
On the detector side, slip ring sending its voltage signal to silver graphite brush to be measured the value at millivolt monitor. The meter has high internal resistance that restricts current flow in the circuit to minimal levels, and thus minimizes the volt drop between the slip ring and the single or monitor brush. The meter therefore accurately displays the potential difference between the shaft and hull. Reading of below 80 mV when shaft is turning at sea indicate proper earthing and current flow from propeller to ship's hull normally. If readings are above 80 mV, an abnormal alarm of SED occur, and there is possibility that the contact between brush and slip rings under bad condition. Therefore, it is necessary to check the condition of slip ring surfaces and brush condition. Cleaning using clean cloths and brushes is necessary. Replace silver brush when it is needed. Also, sometimes there is possibility that shaft propeller surface below slip rings is under corroded condition, causing high resistance. Therefore, it is necessary to be cleaned during docking. The millivolt meter will read zero when shaft is at rest because of the current entering the propeller will return to the hull through main engine bearings or reduction gear and engine foundation. Proper regular maintenance of self-earthing device based on maker instruction is essential in order to prevent art erosion on the main engine bearing, shaft bearing and reduction gear.
I think that's all my video about self-earthing device and rudder bonding cable. Thank you for watching my video. And if you think that my video is useful, please click like and subscribe button. Also, share to others. Sharing knowledge is the easiest way to do charity. And if you have any question or suggestion, please write your comment down below. Anyway, see you in my another video. Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching my video. Your contribution by subscribing my channel is highly appreciated. See you in my another video. Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching my video. Terima kasih, Antonio Project.